Look at me.
Came and took them away. you very much. Thank you all for coming. Well, I'm Markeeta Little Wolf, and I'm very, very pleased to be here tonight for all of you. Thank you again for coming. Now, some of you may be sitting out there in the audience and saying, she doesn't look like she's from Waitsburg. And she sure doesn't sound like she's from Waitsburg. Well, for the two astute members of the audience, you would be right. My father was a Navajo Indian who was brought up on an Indian reservation. My mom is Australian, and she was brought up with no reservations whatsoever. More about her later. But you see, have a look. This is what you get when you cross a savage with a convict. There was a hush, a sigh of relief, when they thought, my God, they could have had more. But no, they didn't. And my father was a professional wrestler and showman. And my dad was touring New Zealand with my very, very pregnant mother, pregnant with me, around the islands. And think circus meets cowboys and Indians. That's what the Wild West show was all about. And they were touring, and my mother was a great child, as I said. My dad had two jobs. The first one was he had to put the step out of the caravan. Now the caravan, let me tell you this, no fifth wheel is here, we're talking primitive. It was no bigger than this stage. And my father, who was like a bear of a man, and my very pregnant mother, lived in this caravan. So my dad's two jobs was to put the step out for my mom so she could get in and out, and to build a fire under a 55-gallon drum full of water so she would have hot water for the day. Well, I think the night before, my dad might have gone to an Italian restaurant and there may have been a glass or two of Chianti. Was that a bottle or two? Anyway, the next morning, he wasn't feeling so great. He remembered the water and the fire, but he forgot the step. Not long after, I made my first public appearance. Funny how a lonely day can make a person say, what good is my life? Funny how a breaking heart can make me stop and say, what good is my life? Funny how I often seem to think I'll never find the dream in my life, till I look around and see this wrecked world. Break I've had in my 2008, Waitsburg City Council. You know who you are.
Too large.
he's an attorney, don't hold it against me. But he's really a yep, nope kind of bloke. When we were first dating, he took me out on a ride. We were always going out on rides. And we went past this pasture of horses. Pretty, pretty horses. Why do I know horses? We went past and I said, "Oh, Michael, look at those pretty horses. What are they?"
"Canners."
"Canners? Canners? I've never heard of that breed. What kind of horse is that?"
"The kind you send to the dog food cannery."
Anyway, let me tell you about my attorney.
Today, I owe it all to you. says we sue, we sue. Bernie says we sigh.
Thank you so much. Well, I get my singing voice from my dad, I think. One of my fondest memories was we would go out and sit outside on our little chaise lounge. And we'd just be sitting there looking at the stars, maybe. And I was just a little girl. And all of a sudden, he would just start to sing. I always remember that about my dad.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble, and the raindrops tumble all around,
over the rainbow. feathers.
Because that's what it's there for. And when you rose and sisters, when you find yourself the two of them, you got that other good hand. You got that good hand. You gotta reach up there. Reach up there to the man up there. Because that's what he's there for.
Operator, give me information. Information.
My mother's so old.
How
that she doesn't leave fingerprints anymore. My mother's so old that she was waiting tables at the Last Supper. My mother's so old that when she went to school, they didn't teach history because there wasn't any. Okay, well, she is, but my mum is the greatest. My father, when I was 9 months old, he had a massive stroke and was never able to work again. So the burden of providing for the family rested on my mother's shoulders, and she opened a hamburger canteen, and she went around to all the different spots, and she slugged her guts out, as we say in Australia. And she took care of us, put me through school, took care of my dad. And then when I finally got the harebrained idea that I was going to follow in my father's footsteps, no, not as a wrestler. She said, all right, kiddo, it's not going to be a free ride. There were piano lessons, there were singing lessons, there was elocution lessons, drama lessons, tap dancing lessons, jazz ballet, you get the picture. And then when it was time for me to start performing, my mother traveled with me always.
She was white. Hello? Hello? Testing, 1, 2, I don't need the bloody microphone. We got a problem, Houston. Anyway, my mother, she traveled with me always. And she looked after me. She was my personal manager. She took care of the finances. She was just there always. And I have, thanks, darling, I have...
Do we need a patch?
thanks, darling. She took care of me. And there were rough times and there were good times, mostly good times, and we always laughed. We would always laugh at everything. And so, Mum, this one's for you.
Sometimes it seemed like you and me against the world. When all the others turned their backs and walked away, you could count on me to say, remember when the circus came to town? Big and strong, and looking out for me and you against the world. Sometimes it seemed like you and me against the world.
There's not a dry seat in the house. Oh, my memory's gone. What's next? Oh, right. Okay. Well, growing up in Australia and wanting to be in show business and having a real bitch, I mean a wonderful mother, we always went to see all the big acts when they would come to Australia. And I saw everybody. I saw Sammy. I saw Frank Sinatra. I saw Cher and Bette Midler and Shirley MacLaine and Tina. Love Tina. Anyway, saw them all. And it was like going to university. You know, you didn't go and pinch stuff. You didn't, you know, try and do their show. But you learnt and you watched and you said, wow, that's how it's done. One performer that really influenced me was someone I never did get to see because unfortunately she took her own life and died way too early. And that person was Janis Joplin. So right now, I'm going to use my psychic powers. I'm going to channel Janis. Like this. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes Benz? My friends all ride Porsches. I must make amends. I worked hard all my lifetime, no help from my friends. So oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes? Color TV. Oh Lord, won't you mind me? Hey.
you're out on the street looking good, baby, deep down in your heart, you know that it ain't right.
Trish, Thompson, and Cathy. It's an inside-out Oreo. And another one of the girls. Maestro himself with the Tyros Orchestra, Mr. Steve Haberman. And Stevie and the girls are going to do a tune for you.
See you, Markeeta. This is our chance to take over the show. You all having a good time out there? Yeah. We're going to party. We're going to party. Here we go. So let the good times roll.
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 I don't care if you're old, baby, let the good times roll. Don't sit there mumbling and speaking trash. If you want to have some fun, you're gonna lose some cash. And let the good times roll.
Let the good times roll.
Let those good times roll.
Let the good times roll.
I took you to Jim German and the whole band knew your name. Oh, babe, you walked in an hour late with your lipstick all a mess. Oh, babe, I got news for you.
I got news for you.
I said your story won't be true. Baby, I got news for you. Now check this one out. You got a brand new watch set. It was from Uncle Joe. I looked at the inscription. It said, love from Stevie. Oh, baby, and we're raring to clown, but don't let nobody sell us cheap. We got 50 cents more than we're gonna keep. So let the good times roll, baby, let the good times roll. You know, Cathy, I said, I don't care whether stormy weather, come on, Trish. Birds of a feather, you gotta flock together. Swingers, come on, you swingers, let the good times roll. Okay, let's do it up.
Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more.
But what you say?
Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back.
When I was going to see all these great performers back in the day, There was always that part in the show where the performer would sit down on a stool. And as a kid, I used to think, why? Now I know. They were old and tired. Star signs, and I believe in film romances. I believe in fantasy, and I believe I cast a spell that sends him to the skies. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. And I believe in Cinderella. I believe in gypsies. And I believe I send him to the sky. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Somewhere songs, they seem to know just what I'm feeling. I believe Prince Charming. I never think he's double dealing. How my spirits rise, believing in the lies of handsome men.
All right, what's next?
You know, the worst thing about getting this show ready was I'm not 28 anymore. I'm not even 40 anymore. Yeah, I'm not even 50 anymore. Oh my God.
Keep going. Hey, let's put a roll on this, okay?
Okay.
Let's do something we've done in LA, okay? You're gonna love this one.
his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he put that old jumba in his jugger bag. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he watched and he waited for his Billy Boyle. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Look out, old Swaggy is back!
Oh, thank you so much. This, I have to tell you, this has been great. You know, the one thing that I am most proud of, other than my marriage to Michael, and you know, I've done a lot of things in my life, and I've had a lot of highs, a few lows, but very, very few. I've been very blessed. But the thing that I am most proud of is that I was the first woman mayor of Waitsburg. And it was great. I really enjoyed my time, and you know, I did manage to do a few things, in spite of some. But I did, and it was a great time, and I really, really love that. And I'm liking this too, you know? I've forgotten how fun this is. Anyway, I want to thank you all for coming. It's been a ball. Here, give yourselves a round of applause. Well, you don't get to this age, and as paraphrasing Rocky Balboa, nothing's going to hit you harder than life. And it isn't that you get knocked down, it's whether you get up again.
Feeling broken, barely holding on.
Just yet, I've been.
Remember I said there was a money back guarantee? I pity the poor fool that comes back there and tries to get 10 bucks out of me tonight. Oh, thank you so much. God bless you all. Oh man, you notice I didn't go very far. I learned a long time ago when I was a kid, I went backstage, I waited, came back, everybody go home. Oh boy. You should rent yourselves out, you're a fabulous audience. Oh, I don't want this to end, it's just been such fun. Again, ladies and gentlemen, Steve Haberman and the Tyros Orchestra. Thank you, man. The wonderful blues act, Trish Thompson and Cathy. And to all the support staff, thank you, you've got your programs, you know who they are. I'm sorry, darling, this old brain, it was hard enough to try and remember 14 songs in there. So,
mate? Thank you to Brooke Floyd, of course, Sam, and Brian's on lights.
Brian's on lights, he's doing a beautiful job, Brian, thank you. And a big thanks, and I hope this is the start of something big here at the Plaza Theatre, a big thanks to Marilyn and Robbie Johnson for giving me this beautiful.
I'll survive.
kids. I'm not gone yet, lad. Just put the house lights down. We're gonna do one more. And
thank you.